This message is being broadcast by the Department of Defense of the Republic. Continue to carry out the following instructions.
All right. My breath smells like garlic because I had the pizza. Well, welcome, guys. Welcome to the stream. I see you guys in the chat. Panther, Assad, welcome. Akemi, hello. Always nice to see you. Lounge Production, hello. ARC. And oh my gosh, it's Paranormiac. Nice. Nice to see you here. Yeah, how are you guys doing? Oh, and Jazz, see ya. How you guys doing? All right, and to answer your question, Louds, I do have gaming consoles. I have a PlayStation 4. I have a Wii U. Really don't use that as much. I also have and Nintendo 64, and a little third-party thing that plays Nintendo and Super Nintendo games. Yeah, it's very fun. All right, so what am I working on? I'm working on a commission. This is a comic commission. It's pretty big. It has to do with Tatsunoko is the best character, Howie, and it's pretty sad. It involves Loud House characters. So, yeah, I'm still doing the Loud House stuff. Yeah, I know. Okay. As always, I'm going to play some music, but it's not going to be Christmas music. I know it's almost Christmas time, but I want to play some other music here. How about some sad, mellow music? And how about you guys? How are you guys doing? No, not that. Akagami-sama 777, welcome to the stream. I don't know what I did there. I was going to sing your name, but I don't know. It sounded like I was whining or something. Good gosh. All right. Dying from work. Yeah, I know how that is. I couldn't wait for this week to end. Now I have a four-day weekend. Yeah. 4-day weekend. So nice. All right. So let's play some songs. Like I said. Yeah, I was about to serenade your name, but I'm not that good of a singer, you know. I'm just saying. You heard me sing at one time. Okay. So let's start. Let's start with some sad, mellow music, since this is a sad commission. Let's do this. Small dinosaur. He's supposed to be a little alligator, but I guess that's my bad for drawing him that way. Oh man, I don't think I can ever do a gaming channel. I mean, originally that was gonna be this channel when I first started. I was gonna do reviews of Super Nintendo games, but that fell on its face. Back in the day when I was so excited to get 5 views in one video when I started. Yeah, I know it's pretty late, considering that I work until 6, my time right now, since we're at winter hours. I had to start this stream late, and I had to shower and eat dinner, so yeah. A lot of speech bubbles to copy. Hey, John Toon Studios, welcome to the stream. Yes, live long and prosper to you too. And Tyrone Black, you all just popped in to say hi. I gotta sleep. Nice. Well, it's always nice to see you, Tyrone, and happy holidays to you too. Oh, and you pulled an all-nighter. I've done that a few times in my college days. They're never a good idea. I remember one time I had to actually I was I pulled an all-nighter, but I wasn't really working on anything. Instead, I was just goofing off on YouTube, and I figured and I found out it was like 4 in the morning. So I'm like, okay, I guess I'll sleep for 2 hours and then go to, and then you'll go to school. Goodness. Good night, Louds. No, oh my gosh, no. Have you watched any good cartoons lately? Well, not really. I mean, I haven't been watching any cartoons, but I've been just watching My Hero Academia on the Funimation. You know, I'm all caught up with it. Now I have to wait like 9 months for the next season to come out. So I'm like, okay, I understand. So might as well get caught up with the manga or something while I'm waiting. Yeah, that's it. Nothing on the cartoon end. I haven't been watching Loud House recently. I used to have it on DVR, you know, record Loud House on DVR, but no. Apparently our satellite dish deleted all of them. And it's not recording any more Loud House. So I'm like, okay, I'm screwed. How can I watch more episodes? And whenever I do catch Loud House live on Nickelodeon, it's like it's an episode I already watched, so might as well wait until the DVDs come out, you know. That's a sucky thing about being into a show that's currently on, you know. Have to wait. All-nighters can save the final, but it's terrible for health. You gotta do what you gotta do, though. I'll watch the stream when it's uploaded later. Well, I finished my last all-night finals. Night, everyone. All right. Good night, Tyrone. I hope you have a wonderful night's rest. I know I had a wonderful night's rest last night. Because I was super tired. I didn't log on in the internet or anything after working 10 hours yesterday and not having a good sleep the night before. I just had to go to bed early. You know. Speaking of which, I did have an interesting dream last night. very weird, but it's pretty entertaining from what I can remember. All I remember is that I was exploring a temple that was like one of those Legend of Zelda temples, but it was like a house. It was like somebody's house. And then I went inside the bedroom, which was the boss's lair. So I fought the bosses, which is like a medium, two medium-sized spiders. I mean, they were like, I mean, don't get me wrong, they were huge spiders, but you know, they were as big as my head or something. One was blue and the other was orange. And so I remembered killing the both of them like you would a Deku Scrub, as in they would spit something and then I pulled up my shield and then it would and then whatever they spat out deflected from my shield and hit them. So that's all I had to do and they're dead. And I saved the house, I guess. And then I remembered some music playing. It was the music from Twilight Princess after you beat a boss in a temple. That soothing melody. But then I was like, and then all of a sudden I was joined by three people. I forgot who the other two were, but the third one was Clint Eastwood. Yeah, Clint Eastwood was with me. And he was like, let's go through Canada. And so we can escort you to Montana. I'm like, yeah. So that's interesting. I'm in my dream world. I'm traveling through Canada on my way to Montana to live there. And Clint Eastwood is with me. And then I woke up. I think there was another part, but I forgot. Yes, Clint Eastwood was with me, man. Oh my gosh. But this was the non-crazy Clint Eastwood, you know? He wasn't talking to an empty chair or anything. Oh no, no, no. Definitely an LOL moment. Oh, gosh. Flatten that one layer without really... I'm going to have to put more speech bubbles in. Yeah, I have some crazy dreams. Usually I have the most vivid dreams whenever I... No, not the circle. Jeez. Okay, mostly I have the most vivid dreams whenever I go to sleep early or whenever I sleep in a strange bed that I'm not used to, like in a hotel or something. That's where I dream. Hey, and don't forget to like this stream, you know, press that like button so YouTube will notice me, you know. Have I ever had any lucid dreams where you can control what's going on? I think I did once, and I think I remembered what happened. I think... Okay, this is what happened in the lucid dream. I was dreaming that I was outside of my house. It was like dark, but it was like purplish. It was like a night sky, a purplish night sky. And I saw a back of the truck. you know, like a bed, you know, the bed of the truck. So I'm like, I was aware at that time, you know, so I was thinking, I want to see Gollum in the back of that truck. And then lo and behold, he just appeared. Gollum from Lord of the Rings appeared on the back of that truck. And then I woke up. That's it. That's what I can remember with the lucid dream, you know. Speaking of lucid dreams, I have a Queensryche song in this playlist called Silent Lucidity. Maybe it will play. You will hear it. And it's all about lucid dreams. But I like it because it's mellow. A bit. Some people say it's sad, but it's not really. It also sounds like a love song, but it really isn't. And the guy who sings it sounds like Roger Waters from Pink Floyd, but he's not. Sounds like he's trying to emulate him. Well, when it comes on, I'll be quiet and let you guys listen to it, since, you know, it is a beautiful song. Have any of my dreams happened in real life? No, not really. I have the weirdest dreams. Like, I have a theory that I'm, like, you dream about a parallel universe. Like, every time I dream about Fairbanks, it looks different, but every time I dream about Fairbanks, I can, they're still the same, locations in the dream world, you know? So every time I dream about school, the school looks the same in the dream world. Of course, it looks different from real life. I'm just saying, because it, you know, it looks different in the dream. Parallel universe. That's what I'm saying. Right. Have you had dreams that Jeff and Taylor were a TV show? I did not, you know, unfortunately. But I did dream about Jeff and Taylor once. They were in a trash can. Like the boys, you know, in real life, I see them, but they're hiding in trash cans. No, I haven't had any dreams about Jeff and Taylor characters or anything. Speaking of which, I'm excited for next year, because I'm going to be working on Jeff and Taylor, and I'm going to be working on some exciting projects about them. Episode 15 script is almost done, so I'll be working on that at the very start of the year, 2019. And I'm going to probably postpone the next batch of quickies until April or something, so I can focus on episode 15. Maybe Jeff lost his glasses, and that's why they were in the trash cans looking for his glasses. Yeah, although, if I remember correctly, they looked disappointed or something. Maybe they didn't find the glasses there, so that's why they're disappointed. I don't know, man. I feel like Lisa is my least favorite character in the Loud House, because all the awkward stuff that makes me uncomfortable in the show, it's usually she's the culprit, you know? Either her or Lily, the baby, you know? And Lincoln here, every time I draw him, he's not on model, according to the show. In the show, his head is huge compared to his body, but me, I always draw his body taller than it's supposed to be. I wonder if people still like my Loud House stuff because I was a superstar 2 years ago. That's where I gained a lot of my new subscribers and followers. It was because of the Loud House, you know. If I were to upload something new, they'll be like, you're still into this show? But at the same time, I don't want to be known as a Loud House artist for the rest of my life. I want to be the creative Jeff and Taylor, you know? And look at me, I'm talking all the time. You know, I'm super chatty. I am super chatty tonight. Maybe it's because it's nighttime, you know? And I get kind of crazy at night. Hey JFM, so I was wondering about copywriting comics or animation. When copywriting, does the idea have to be finalized? Because, you know, ideas change. Yes, for the most part. Usually, you know, when you want to copyright something, you copyright the actual book, you know, instead of an idea. You can't copyright the idea itself. Like, you can't write to the Library of Congress and say that, hey, this is my idea, I want it copyrighted. They have to have something physical. Physical, or you send you send proof of your property, you know? That's why next year I want to resubmit my Jeff and Taylor volumes to copyright them instead of copyrighting the episodes themselves, you know, because the volumes are physical copies. Oh, TD Camper, I'm sorry, I missed you. Welcome to the stream. Me? No, I haven't watched any Ben 10 ever. I feel like that was, that was made in a time where I was not watching any cartoons, any new cartoons, because I felt like they were bad. If you remember my early YouTube days, I would rant a lot about current cartoons and how I'm going to save the country from all these bad shows, you know. But then I chilled out as soon as Gravity Falls came out. I'm like, okay, there's hope. How much does it cost to get a copyright of for making a graphic novel series? Well, you know, you copyright every book at a, you know, one book at a time, I guess. But if I remembered, it cost me $35 for a submission. It was either $35 or $75. For submission. Ok, Artwork. I am finalizing a comic commission for Tatsunoko is the Best. That's what I'm working on. Your commission, on the other hand, I will be doing that in a stream on Monday, along with another commission. Then after that, I want to take a break from commissions, because, you know, I want to focus on episode 15 of JNT, you know. That's right, I said Monday. Monday will be a stream because I have the day off. Oh my gosh. Yes, I am excited. It's not every day that I get a day off, you know. How about you guys? Do you have to work or something? It's okay if you do. You know, you're doing you're help making the world go around, but at the same time, I wish you had a day off. You know, I know I'll be busy tomorrow, not with work, but with other stuff. That's right, 4-day weekend. Woo! Okay. But yeah, episode 15 is gonna be awesome. I'm gonna introduce a new villain, Captain Starla, and I think people will like her. You're gonna love her and hate her. Oh, nice. Nice that your mother is coming over to visit. Episode 15 would be awesome, and if I were to focus on making like if I were to finish, like actually finish 5 pages a week, I can actually make it to the end of March or something, or mid-March, excuse me.
Instead of you driving out, or you and I driving out, I can put your truck behind the 1500 in the toilet can. It lets me get the 1500 out of here before we go. So, put it up on a U-Haul trailer, I just tow it down. And either you can go with me, or my dad's willing to fly up, or Cindy can go with me, or whatever. And then if you don't, you can just fly and just go camp and pick it up. So,
what? I saw. Oh, you want to try to use it? Okay, once I.
So that's one option to think about. Because it gives us a chance to get our truck out of here, too. Uh-huh. And I know my truck can make that trip without a problem. I said, whether you go or I go or whoever, you're not driving my truck. You and I can either go, or Cindy and I can go. And you fly or whatever. What was the other thing I came up with? That was the main thing. I kind of like that option because my truck had it too.
Yeah, that's something.
But just think about it. You don't have to decide today, but that kind of figure it out. Just another option for you to use.
Whatever is easy.
There's one way, but I'd rather drive my truck down than yours. So,
by far, I'd much rather drive my truck.
all right. And that way it's, well, like I said, I checked the U-Haul website. They'll let me tow your truck in the lane of mine. So that's not a problem. It's the only one that I think it's more than the truck store. So.
Okay.
That's a little bit about it.
All right. All right, I am back. I don't know if you guys heard that conversation. Oh no, Paranormac. Oh, you have to leave? Okay. Yeah, understandable. You're on the East Coast, so yeah, it's past 12 over there. Yeah, but good night. Hope you have a great night, a great weekend, and a happy holidays, Paranormac. G. Okay. Seth Wayne, welcome to the stream. Oh, yeah, great. You heard it. Yeah, no problem. Hope you have a great night. Have great dreams. Dream about Jeff and Taylor. Dream about your characters. Okay. Yeah, just weighing in some options about how about my move and everything. That was my brother-in-law. Yep. That's him. Since they're moving out of state in the same time frame as me. Yeah, he said a couple options, saying that we instead of me driving through Canada, we drive together and we just tow my truck since it's smaller than his or something. So, yeah, that's one option. Another option is sending my truck out to Spokane or something. Then I can pick it up from there. I fight a Spokane and whatever, or something. It's all in the planning stages, I still have about 5 months or so. Yes, thank you so much, Seth Wayne, for the holiday hugs. And yeah, since you love the Loud House, I am drawing something Loud House related. It has to do with Howie the Alligator, but still. He is part of Sean's little Fannin? Yeah, Fannin, that's what it's called. Hey, JFM, sometimes I wonder how many comic projects do you currently have? Just curious, also, what's way of organizing them? Because I overthink my ideas to the point I don't know how to organize them. Well, yeah, I can understand that. But I have a few comic ideas and projects. They're just in the planning stages and everything. I'm not actually writing them down or drawing them out since I'm always changing my mind, especially with Malice Mansion. White Man Extreme is pretty simple. Jeff Adventure or Project JA, I'm still thinking of the main plot and trying to figure out how the heroes, the characters, can be relatable and likable and all that. Because after seeing all these heroes and other shonen like Deku from My Hero Academia, everybody loves him because he's so vulnerable. But Jeff Majica, he's not vulnerable, so I gotta be careful with him. Since it's like he's entering Gary Stu's status or something. So I still have a lot to think about, and I still have a lot of time. I'm not gonna work on them until Jeff and Taylor is done. It will be a while. S-Tunist, welcome to the stream. Sorry it took a while to say hi, but hey, always nice to see you. Oh no, this is a nice alligator. Howie is very gentle. very sensitive. He's a kid alligator. Not my character. He's Sean's character, the client. I think he's my most loyal client. Of course, he commissions other artists, but he commissions me a lot. Good thing these characters are simple, easy to do line work and color and everything. Oh yeah, Demon City. Yeah, I can't wait till that's done. I'm still trying to figure out what I'm going to do with it. Either a straightforward comic or a choose your own adventure or something. The song that you're hearing now is from Tenchi Muyu or Tenchi Universe, and it's one of the animes that I've watched for the first time. You know, it's one of my early animes. I just say that it was Dragon Ball Z, Tenchi Universe, and Pokemon. Those are my very first animes that that I watched when I was like 10 and 11 years old. You know. Some people say Tenchi Universe is like a harem series, but it's not. You know. I mean, it does have some harem tropes, but to me, it's not raunchy enough to be a harem series, you know. And those can be quite raunchy, especially the Sekirei series. Have you ever seen Sekirei? Sekirei is like that anime that I watched in like 2014. I would say, I remember a Funimation did the English dub, but it only lasted for 2 seasons, and then they didn't make a season 3, which was bad because they left on a cliffhanger. And yeah, I would say it's an action series, and it's also it's a harem series too, and you see some topless, big-breasted women there. Yeah, it's I'm explaining Sekirei with this background music. Oh my gosh, but it's I would say it's part ecchi. You know, it's not a hentai or anything. It's an ecchi. And they pull off the whole tropes that you see in every harem anime. There's a busty girl. There's a tsundere girl, if that's what it's called. There's a nerdy girl. There's a little girl. It's like, my gosh, man. Chill out. Like, this guy has all these girls, you know, fawning over him. I'm talking way too much. Sorry, you guys probably can't keep up with me. But it is Friday night. Well, thank you. And Yeah, sorry, Jazz. I'm not doing music requests today because, you know, I'm just not in the mood for them. Plus, the last time I did it, you know, my stream got blocked. You know? Maybe, you know, next time or in a couple more streams, I will accept music requests. I think a harem series varies upon each person's perspective and definition. For me, if there's a lot of girls wanting one dude, it's harem. But to each his own. Yeah. That makes sense. I mean, people say that Tenshin Muyo is a harem series, but at the same time, there's only two girls that really want him. That's Ryoko and Ayaka. The other girls just, you know that he's there, and they don't. I mean, yeah, they do flirt with him, but at the same time, they're not very serious. So they don't want to start a relationship with him. So I don't count that. Yeah, exactly. Rosario X Vampire is a good harem anime. Huh. Never heard of it. Might watch it one day. You know, I'll probably have a lot of time when I move. My main Seth Wayne account actually, YouTube won't allow me to send screen messages, so I legit just made another one for you, Jeff. Oh, nice. Thank you. Man, sometimes YouTube will be acting crazy. Maybe it's revenge for what I've said about that YouTube rewind. Oh, here we go. Here's the song I was talking about earlier. Silent Lucidity by Queensrÿche. This is about lucid dreams. So, yeah, hope you enjoy this song, and hopefully you won't get this stream blocked. It's very nice.
feeling safe in bed. It was all a bad dream spinning in your head. Your mind tricked you to feel the pain of someone close to you leaving the game. Chance. Wide awake, you face the day, the dream is over. Or has it just begun? There's a place I like to journey in your head.
All right, so that was it. That was the song. Hopefully you guys liked it. I know it's been a while since I heard it, and I got the feels. And I'm sorry, Seth Wayne. Sorry about that. So JFM, do you have any tips for sharing original characters and stories online? I'm very protective of my ideas, but at the same time, I do want to share them. I don't know how much though. Well, if you have a secret character, you know, I guess, you know, don't share him too much, but, you know, don't be afraid to share, you know, characters, because in my experience, nobody ever stole, you know, Jeff and Taylor or something. They would make parodies, you know, make their own original characters, which are just, you know, Jeff and Taylor clones, but they never really claimed Jeff and Taylor as their own thing. And I guess it's because they can sense I'm very serious about my stuff, and probably I told them right away that they're copyrighted. At the same time, you know, if I keep uploading videos and pictures of my stuff, that's proof, that's evidence that it's your own thing. So if a person tries to steal it, you know, they can't. Oh, Akagami, YouTube is trying to pull apart from the coding of Google Plus. Yeah, I heard they're trying to get rid of Google Plus. I don't know what that will happen. That is right, legal rights. Legal rights. But yeah, thank you for liking the song. It's a very nice song. Same with this. It's The Killing Moon by Nouvelle Vague. Yes, ARC, I've heard of YouTube Rewind 2018. I've seen the stupid video and I didn't like it. I thought I explained this in my last stream. Maybe you weren't there, but yeah, I didn't like it. I really don't know who that is. Jaden. The only person I recognize in that YouTube Rewind thing was Will Smith. That's it. I gave it a 1 out of 10 because, you know, that one was Will Smith. Oh man, if OMN Comic was here, he would love to hear this, since, you know, he said he loves this song. This is I Love You by the Bees.
There's no lies I wouldn't make you cry.
I just got the update on my phone. It's going to be negative 7 degrees tomorrow. Right here in town. Meanwhile, I'm getting like 20s and 30s. I was prepared this winter for another rough snow year, but I haven't been getting a whole lot. Yeah, I heard, like I saw on the news, that that Great Falls was like 23 degrees or something. Then I looked at my phone and noticed that Helena was at 30 degrees. I'm like, dang. Hopefully it'll be like that next year when I move, you know, a late winter for me. I've never experienced a late winter that. But then again, it is abnormal, so I really shouldn't be celebrating that. Texas. Does it actually snow in Texas? Like, I know probably in the northern area. Oh yeah, here you go, Titus's theme. This song always helps me whenever I'm feeling sad or down about something. I play this song in my headphones, pretend it's the soundtrack of my life, and just listen away, and I feel better. Never snows in Florida, yeah. It never snows in Somerville either. Somerville is Jeff and Taylor's hometown, home city. You know. Yeah. Hey, it's Altarf, everybody. Welcome to the stream. Oh, I didn't get to see your X23 sketch. I didn't log in. What kind of accent was that? I didn't log in to DeviantArt or Instagram. Let's see. I'm in Instagram right now. Oh, there it is. I see it. Yeah, she's wearing a Wolverine mask and everything. Very nice. You ought to work for Marvel. You have amazing work. Yeah, you're welcome. Ah, thank you very much, Seth Wayne. Thanks, Zach. It's been nice talking to you too, and I'll see you later. No, I didn't get a chance to see the Bumblebee movie. I don't have any time to watch any movies. Even the movies that I really want to see, like Creed 2 and Wreck-It Ralph 2. Man, I keep forgetting that they're on, and I'm like, oh man, I have to go home and work. I have to go home and sleep because I get out of work around 6, and even on the weekends, I'm like, I don't want to go because there's too many people. You know, might as well just wait till it comes out on DVD or something. I don't know. But definitely, once I move to Helena, I'll have a lot of more time and opportunity to go to the movies. Wreck-It Ralph 2 was alright for me, but I can't help but still admiring the first movie. Hopefully you get to see it to form your own opinion of it. Yeah. I mean, you know. I will definitely watch it one of these days. Definitely. I heard it's really, really good. At the same time, you know, got to hold my own opinion on it. You know, I did like the first one. Then again, I only watched it once. I remember that was, I watched it in theaters with my then girlfriend, Destiny. We were on a double date. It was me and her parents. And we watched Wreck-It Ralph together, and it was nice. Nice experience, but that was the only time I watched it. Yeah, you know, they didn't treat me like that. You know, they trusted me. Of course, I'm always a gentleman with the ladies, you know. But no, they were right next to us, and they enjoyed the movie too. I remember her dad was like complaining about a guy that was talking, giving his little commentary about the movie. Hate that. You know, that's the bad part about going to movie theaters, is that you never know who will be there. That's why I like to go when there are, you know, at certain times and certain days where there's not a lot of people in the theater. Like, let's say Tuesday morning or afternoon, No one goes to the movie theater at that time, so I'll go there. It's, yeah. Now, if it's of my own movie, if it's a Jeff and Taylor movie, then I would want a lot of people there, and I would sit my ass in the back row, just anticipating everybody's reactions to the movie. That would be awesome. Lucky for you, in Helena, the theater isn't so packed, even when busy. Now try Bozeman. The line will be wrapping around the block. I can imagine, because Bozeman is a very, like what you explained, Bozeman is a very populated city. In the Montana area, in the state. Man, I guess Bozeman is the Anchorage of Montana, you know? Because Anchorage is the most populated city in Alaska, but it's not the capital. It was the city that got hit by a 7.2 magnitude earthquake a couple weeks ago, and miraculously no one died or got hurt. And we fixed a collapsed street in like 4 days. So that's awesome. It's time for color. I have the references here. Pray. Okay. No, it's just a fantasy, you know, freaking, you know, wishful thinking about the Jeff and Taylor movie, you know. I wish it was real. Fun fact, actually, the most populated city in Montana is Billings, so that would be the Anchorage of Alaska, in a sense. Oh, okay. Got it. Billings, Montana. No, I have a friend who lives in Augusta, Montana right now, but he went to high school with me. Actually, no, he went to all three schools with me, from elementary all the way to high school. His name is Kevin Alt. He can be a cheesy man. At the same time, you know, he's very, very opinionated, especially about movies. He hates Star Wars, The Force Awakens with a passion. It made him hate it made him hate Star Wars, basically, that Force Awakens movie. So I'm like, whoa, he's very opinionated. But still, he says that Billings is like a terrible city, and he doesn't want to work there or move there or anything. So I'm like, whoa, okay, stay away from Billings then. If I'm afraid to go to Billings, blame Kevin. Jeff, you in Montana? I misheard earlier Canada. Oh, I meant I'm going to move to Montana next year, next summer. But I want to take my truck with me because, you know, I don't want to spend money on a new vehicle. And I love my truck, you know. I put so much work into it. I don't wanna, you know, get rid of it. So I'm planning to drive through Canada, but there's other options that my brother-in-law told me about. He may be a pain sometimes, but at the same time, you know, he has experience, especially when it comes to driving long distances. So, I gotta trust him on this. So might as well have the company, you know? Yeah, trust him. I went to Billings for a concert with my friend one time, and yeah. All right, you're gonna have to share details with me. Like the next time we have a chat or something. Or maybe you want to share them right now. It all depends on what you want. Now, you may be wondering what's going on in this comic. It's based off of a scene in Home Improvement. Yeah. Sean, he likes to add these references to his commissions. It's usually a reference to an old 80s cartoon or a sitcom. All right, I'm looking forward to the next chat then. And tell me all about Billings and what happens there. You know Sage Windfeather? The online artist? I think she lives in Billings. But I think she's going to move soon. Now, this is a commission for a client. You know? This is his original character, Howie the Alligator. And he wants me to draw him, of course. I've drawn Howie plenty of times. Comic commission, so that's why it's a big scene. There's Lisa, that's the reference I had, so I'm gonna copy her hair and color her. There. How am I? Oh, well, thank you for asking. Yeah, I am pretty content right now. I've been pretty happy for the last couple weeks or so. But you know, sometimes the tiniest thing will put me in a sad mood. So I like to write this out. You know, write this, you know, happiness a little bit longer. Hopefully nothing will make me sad. No awkward moments when I'm talking to people, you know, since that happens. No misunderstandings. No overthinking. Thank you so much. You know, I try to be very careful on my mood when I do videos, you know, because, you gotta live out that happiness while you can. Take it for granted. That's right. But I try my best to be in a good mood whenever I do videos and all that, because, you know, every time I'm in a bad mood or sad in a video, it always backfires, you know. All right, see you later, ARC. Thank you for joining the stream. All tough. I realize awkwardness and misunderstandings are unavoidable. Just gotta catch when they come. That's right. It's like a sixth sense or something. Holy Coke, and yes, have you seen the newest Angry Video Game Nerd or the newest videos by Cinemassacre? They actually have the real Macaulay Culkin in them, you know, making a guest appearance and everything. He appeared in like three videos already. He appeared in an AVGN episode, and then it was Mike and James, or James and Mike's Monday, when he reviewed Pagemaster, and just today he reviews Big Trouble in Little China or something. So, dang, man. I really like James Rolfe. And I really believe in my heart of hearts that he should be like the most subscribed person on YouTube. Like, I'm surprised he only has like 2.5 million people watching him. That's not right. He should have like 25 million or something. More than that. The dude puts so much work into his videos. And he wants to be a director. He has ambition, you know? He's not doing it just for the money. That's right. That's why I had him in my featured page in volume 4. Is that cool? La la la. La la la. I never even heard of 5 minute crafts. Oh my gosh. 43 million? I have no idea. I don't know who's these subscribers. I don't know if they're fake accounts. I don't know if they're children. Or what? Oh, crafts, okay. Oh, well, people like their crafts. Guess it helps. At the same time, you want to be entertained? Well, watch James Rolfe. And JFM Studios. No. Still. Alright, I think I'm gonna do the flat color and everything, and then I'll call it quits for the stream, since it'll be almost 2 hours by then. I think it's all about based on algorithms, really. People you think should be more popular than they are because they aren't working with the algorithm, which is kind of what makes YouTube a bit broken. Yeah, that makes sense. Damn algorithm. Damn Google. Kind of wish YouTube and Google... I kind of wish Google didn't own YouTube. Wish YouTube was its own thing, you know? back in the good old days when I was watching YouTube back in 07 and 08. Man, mostly I was just watching it for like the dumb music, the music videos and the dumb YouTube poop series, you know. And all those edits, those are funny. Real funny, especially when they're made in Windows Movie Maker. Those were the best. No, I forgot to mention, we were talking about harem series, or harem animes, and I forgot to mention that people like Loud House fans call the Loud House a harem anime jokingly, but at the same time, they're kind of serious, especially with their fan art, you know. Well, it used to be, but companies see dollar signs in their eyes and gotta make more money because what they have apparently isn't enough. Businesses grow and expand, and it's that nature, unfortunately. Yeah, especially when certain cable companies or telecommunication companies purchase, studios, you know, and media companies. Case in point, AT&T. They bought Time Warner, so that means they own all of Warner Brothers cartoons and DC Comics and all Turner channels like CNN and TNT, TBS, Cartoon Network. AT&T owns them. Man, I'm kind of tempted. When I moved down to Montana, I would want to get rid of my cell phone, so I won't have to deal with AT&T and switch to a new provider or something. I wonder if they have T-Mobile down there. I was going to mention that, Jeff, how people call Loud House a harem. Yeah. I was gonna say, and Disney bought Fox and Marvel, and yeah, a lot of companies bought a lot of stuff. Yes, we do. We have T-Mobile. Okay, cool. I'm gonna see if I can, bring my cell phone in and say, hey, I would like a new cell phone and a new provider. T-Mobile. I mean, last time I checked, T-Mobile wasn't trying to buy anything or trying to destroy net neutrality, you know. All they did was build a new arena in Las Vegas. Or at least they bought the name. You know, this T-Mobile Arena in Vegas. That's where you see a lot of boxing matches. T-Mobile Arena, yeah. All right. Yeah, Disney is so weird. I mean, they try to be this huge juggernaut, and I heard online just recently that they try to buy the trademark to Hakuna Matata, which is a Swahili phrase. So they're trying to, buy copyright or trademark of a phrase of an already existing language. That's just weird. Come on, Disney. What are you doing? I'll never work for you. I don't know. People are like, no, man, it's a good thing that Disney bought Fox, or 20th Century Fox, their studio department. Because, we get the X-Men back. Come on, man. Yeah, and Paris Hilton tried to copyright the phrase. That's so hot. A lot of people doing dumb stuff. Yes. Oh, man. I remember that. I remember the good old days when Paris Hilton was like the most controversial person on TV. Now nobody talks about her anymore. But still, that is a stupid thing that she tried to do. You know, try to copyright. That's so hot. When JFM goes from morning streams to late night streams, yeah. The difference is I'm a lot more talkative in the late night streams. And there's less people watching. Oh man. How's my video quality? Because YouTube is saying that it's bad right now. How's the audio? As long as you guys can hear me, that's all right. All right, good. All right, cool. You know, I guess YouTube is just tripping, you know. They're threatening me. It's like, hey, this JFM guy is talking crazy shit about us. Yeah, you take it, YouTube. Take it up the arse. Don't cut me off again. Donut. I know. They also do 78 Sports TV dirty too. You know, he's a YouTuber that I listen to. He usually talks about boxing and all the news that happens, but he does live streams, and even YouTube, they're like taking away his ability to do super chats and everything. That's messed up. That's good. That's a good volume. It's too loud. I don't know what he's saying, but it has to be about love or something. Because, you know, he said "Aishiteru," which I think is Japanese for "I love you." Maybe. "Aishiteru," you know. I think that's "I love you" in Japanese. I could be wrong. Oh my gosh. Daisuke yo is "I love you." Oh, awesome. Okay. Then I don't know what "Aishiteru" means then. Oh, okay. Just like in Spanish, there's "te quiero" and "te amo." Usually when you say "te amo" means "I love you" in a romantic way, as in "I want to marry you, I want to make love to you, I want to live with you forever, I love you for who you are inside and out, I will protect you, never make you sad again, I never want you to be sad again." And "te quiero" means "I love you" in a more casual way. Like you say to a family member, "te quiero." Yeah, that's my little Spanish lesson of today. Well, I won't, Lotso. I won't give it to Disney, you know. If I were to choose a studio to take care of Jeff and Taylor, it would have to be like Universal Studios, which owns, they do the, what are they called? Minions, yeah, the Minions. They do the Minions and Despicable Me. They're those guys. Yeah, just like that. There are various forms depending upon the status of the person, recipient, receiving it. Yeah, exactly. Not even flex tape. Yeah, flex tape can't fix their issues either. Yeah. Man, I don't know how a live-action Jeff and Taylor movie would look like. I mean, how would Blue look like? You know, they would probably ruin her hair, make her have regular ass pigtails. They're gonna say, "Oh no, it's realistic." You know, come on, no, man, Jeff and Taylor isn't meant to be realistic. Yeah, it's down to earth and kind of grounded in reality, but at the same time, it has some supernatural stuff. So, my characters have to look a bit supernatural too. Exactly. Some things are better animated, like The Simpsons. You know, The Simpsons work as a animated series. And it's a good thing they don't have a live-action adaption or anything like that.
Yeah, I think it's the screen. Yeah.
A 3D film of J&T would be interesting. I know I want Project JA to be 3D. As good as a cutscene of a Final Fantasy game, you know, that kind of 3D. CG, you know, computer animated. But with Jeff and Taylor, I would prefer 2D. That's right. We need more 2D movies. What? Oh my gosh. You showed your friends Jeff and Taylor and they loved it? Nice. Thank you so much, Jazz. That means the world to me that you showed other people Jeff and Taylor. Yes, man. You know? And I hope they're gonna be, you know, frequent, you know, visitors of the website. I'm almost done with the episode 15 script, so I really want to get that episode out by March or something. Would you like it in the style like Nightmare Before Christmas or Coraline? Oh, that's like stop motion? Maybe not for Jeff and Taylor as a series, but if it's like a special episode or something that you know, plays around with that animation, that style, then yeah, I would. It has to be like just a one episode thing, you know. Do 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 do. I'm sorry, it's 9:29 here. And of course I get a little crazy at night. March, me, October. Hey now, that's, I know I'm slow, but you know, I'm trying to be motivated here. The reason why episode 14 took so long is because I was working on quickies at the same time and preparing myself for cons and all that jazz. So I'm really gonna focus on episode 15 at the beginning of the year. That's okay. We are all sort of crazy in our own ways. That's right. Stop motion is so hard and it takes a long time. Since the 1930s, I think there's only been like 80 stop motions I've heard. Wow, that's it? Dang, it is a rare thing. Stop motion. Yeah, that's right, Panther. I am still drawing, but I'm almost done with this stream. This is a big project here, a big comic page, so of course it'll take me a while. Oh yeah, Aardman. Yeah, I did watch like one Wallace and Gromit movie. I know I watched Chicken Run. That was good. A stop motion movie with dead bugs, and it's really fascinating. Yeah. Dang. Yeah, I can imagine them doing that. I mean, it's easy to do if they're dead, you know. Okay, just gotta color Lisa's pants and shoes, and then I'm done, I guess. I remember there was like a news article saying that Chicken Run made kids not want to eat chicken because it made them feel sad. For the chicken, I'm like, oh, okay. Of course, I forgot how old I was when that movie came out. I was probably 10 or something.
Thank you.
Okay. I think I'll call it a night with this. In the meantime, let me show you what else I'm doing. Oh yeah, Dragon of My Dreams. That is a good little documentary that he did. I love that. It's in my favorites list. Yeah, thank you very much. I don't think I ever showed you this. This is going to be in my next t-shirt, a Jeff t-shirt. I'm not a procrastinator, I just work great under pressure. Yeah, that's him, all right. He's very good at schoolwork, but he does them like a minute before they're due. That's how he is. He doesn't believe in doing homework at home. All I gotta do is make a tailor shirt, figure out what he's gonna say, and then I'll submit him to Redbubble, and I'll have two more shirts that I own. Yeah, see how that works out for you in a stressful life and death scenario. Yep. there will be moments where his life will be on the line, literally, where he has to fight, you know, certain people. I think that already happened in the comic, you know, fighting G Station and EG and DJ, you know, those guys. Yeah, the end of year artwork slideshow that I upload every New Year's Eve, that's going to be lit. Thank you so much. Oh yeah, here's a little project I'm gonna start next year. This little drawing here, or actually, I haven't started yet. It's gonna be my own little parody of this. Yeah, the wrong number. R.L. Stine. Yeah, this little picture. I want to do my own version where it's you know, Jenny and Trina. And I'm gonna put somebody outside. I don't know who. They're like stalking them. It's like if Jenny and Trina were to be a comic series, then that'll be the cover or something. It's gonna be a little spoof of this. I don't know who the artist is. I would credit him, but. Yeah. Hmm, 2016 when JFM drew one picture. What one picture? I drew a lot of pictures in 2016. 2014 was a bad year of art, basically. Same with 2009, you know. I always keep saying to you guys that 2009 was an awful year for me, but so was 2014, you know, in life and in art, you know. I can tell because I measure my artwork slideshow videos. And that was only like 10 minutes or so. Usually my slideshows last like 13 minutes or something. 2013 was a good year of art. 2016 was an amazing year of art. 2017 was okay. This year was okay. I want next year to be amazing. Oh, I'm also working on this. Lynn's Dream. This is how far I've gotten. I have Lynn sleeping and everything, and I have her as a reference. Just gotta have other things. I have other stuff for references. I have this. I have Pacifica Northwest. Dipper, he's gonna be in it. Mabel. And this is a drawing from Master Rainbow, just so I can tell how he draws. You know, he's very good at the Loud House art style, so I'm like using him, his art as a reference. So I know how to draw the right kind of boxing gloves and everything, and the ring. So that's gonna be awesome. Master Rainbow did that. Yeah, Luann is a bit underrated, can't lie. Oh yeah, 2019 will be a great year, personally, and in my art life. Yeah, it's gonna be great. I gotta imagine it. I gotta manifest it. You know, gotta meditate. Let's see, what else do I have to show you? I'm still continuing the airplane pictures. Like I have Learn to Fly 9. You know, those pictures that I was working on with Jeff and Taylor as pilots and everything. All right, here's one I'm working on. All right. Okay, so Jeff and Taylor, they are not flying the plane, and they replaced them with a trash bag and a pillow with King Tut's head, so they can trick whoever's walking in, because they're taking a break, you know, it's on autopilot. A lot of people like Lucy Loud. Let's see, let's open. What else? Oh, dang. I gotta go to DeviantArt like after this and upload some new stuff. Oh, those two, they're probably in the back drinking with the passengers. Yeah, that'll calm them down, knowing that both pilots are not flying a plane. Oh, dang. Yeah, I forgot to mention. I made the new commercial for Jeff and Taylor, you know, Across the Great Divide, you know, the second Quickies book. It'll be almost out on Indie Planet. I just got confirmed that it'll take a while, but it will be on Indie Planet, so it can be sold online. So I already made the commercial, and I really want to show it to you guys. But not now. I'll show it to you in a, you know, real soon. And I'll upload it on my other channel when the book is actually out. It's live, you know. And let's go back to the very beginning of the year where I always draw a Jane picture. I drew this on January 1st of this year. Fucking Jane, yeah. She's looking awesome. So yeah, I'm going to be drawing another Jane picture January 1st. Just got to figure out what. I'll be doing a little DeviantArt poll, see what people want. Last year, they voted for Rockstar Jane, so I drew her like this with her five-string guitar. That was a mistake. Usually, guitars have six strings. Bass guitars have four strings, but this one has five strings, which is like, oh boy, I don't know. Yeah, and I love the colors. I love the purple and pink and, you know, and the blue. Let's see here, let's open my other picture, my Amanda picture, my little mantra for this year. It's not, well, here we go. Yes. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I also drew this in the beginning of the year too. Amanda on top of the stairs, based on the song by Skilo. You don't know who Skilo is? He's the rapper who sings my other theme song. I wish. When I make my own commercial, I don't know. I know soon. You'll see the new commercial very soon, and it's funny. I had a lot of fun. I'm putting it together. It's great. And all these goals that she has, you know, comic work, not focus on bad things, do good, and find love. And she wants plans for 2018. Yeah. That's what she wants. Yeah, this was the first time I drew her with glasses and the big ponytail and the flannel shirt. Yeah. She looks cool. She's just dressed like this just because, you know, a new look, new type of little style for her. Man, I don't want to stop this. I want to keep showing you stuff. Let's see if in my other folders I have something. The Amanda folder, FSW. Scary Stuff, Uncle Link, Demon City. Oh, thank you. I think it's the Watson, Jeff and Taylor. I guess I do have this. Starhammer letters. You guys know Team Starhammer, right? All right. All right. I was going to do a little something called Starhammer letters, which I would hide it in the Jeff and Taylor comic website. And people would find them and read them. It was like little clues about Team Starhammer. And this is a little letter from the boss, Risotto. And he writes, "Welcome. Let me introduce myself. I'm Risotto, the head honcho of Team Starhammer. So glad you attended orientation. Have you tried the fried cannolis yet? They are the shit. Don't eat too much of them, or else you end up fat like me. Besides, if I catch you eating too much of them, well, I'm going to have to put you in the old cement shoes." Laughing out loud. "But seriously, know your place, maggot. Anyways, have fun breaking the law for me. You know, I started this organization with my best friend, rest his soul, about 25 years ago. And slowly, we're grabbing Somerville by the throat. I think this is the year we're finally going to make a huge impact in this stinking town. You're lucky to join us at this pivotal moment of history. Now get to work. Mean face. Risotto." Yes. There are letters that I used to do. I made 4 in total. But yeah. Little clues for the audience. That's it. I should continue them. But hey. Okay. Communism. Well, let's see. Risotto wrote a second letter. All right. Okay, he says, hey, it's been 10 days. 10 freaking days since the toilet started to back up. I'm pissed off. I would like to call for the plumber, but I don't want the Mookie knowing where our secret hideout is at. Even if he did arrive, I would have to whack him and throw him in the river after he fixes the toilets. I had Frank try to fix the damn system, but the idiot made things worse by breaking the pipes with bullets. I tried to shoot the clog away. I would fire the bum, but I need him for a fetch quest. Nobody else is stupid enough to do them. So, anyways, if any of you can do our humble boss a favor, could you steal a plumber for me? Just make sure he's blindfolded and have a gun pointed at him for dramatics. Thank you kindly, Risotto. The fact that he had to write this and he was laughing and giving the scowl makes me think, is this guy for real or just being a comedian? Hold. I haven't introduced Risotto yet. We'll find out what kind of person he is in Jeff and Taylor, which is, at the end of the day, a lighthearted comic. Okay. Yep. Freaking Lucy with her trying to flush her book down the toilet. Yeah, that's a good idea. If someone made a J&T game, they should put these notes around the map. Yeah, and you find them. That's going to be awesome. It's like a little fetch quest, a little mini game. You collect all of them, you get a trophy. Or achievement, that's going to be lit. It's going to be awesome. If Jeff and Taylor were to ever be a game, I would like it to be like Grand Theft Auto, you know, kind of open world sandbox game going around Somerville. You control Jeff or Taylor, or, you know, you can switch between the both of them, just like Grand Theft Auto 5 with their characters. There are some missions that's only for Jeff, some missions that are only for Taylor, and for the main story missions, you have to have both of them do them or something. Yeah. That's how he is. I can see Jacob's intentions a bit more clearer. Yep. Jacob is a more serious guy. But Risotto isn't the only guy to write letters. We've got one of the executives, Maxine, which you've seen in episode 12? Yeah. Well, hello everyone. It's member number 3, Maxine. Today I will report our statistics for the month of July. I am somewhat pleased, but there are a few splinters that need to be plucked. So far we have 47 Starhammer members. 200,906,784 in our bank. Gained one more donor, Frisbee's Traveling Circus. Invented stain-free socks. Now, I have a problem with the socks. Why are we spending precious money from our bank to invent useless things? I told you idiots in the tech division to invest things that make this organization goals easier. Don't make me get the belt. Actually, no. Some of you enjoy the belt too much. Yeah. That's Maxine. She's one of the executives, and she has her own plans for Team Starhammer 2. She wants to go to a more, supernatural route. As in, she wants help from demons and junk like that. She believes in the occult and wants them, wants help. Okay, and every letter I have this beginning. It's like a letterhead, you know. That will work. Threaten to cut off a limb. All right, so here's their little logo here. Team Starhammer, crime, organized crime syndicate, and grammar Nazis. Parts unknown, Somerville. All right, so we have the other executive, Frost, which you've seen in episode 14. He's the old man with the sweater, the Bill Cosby sweater. He's like, hello, Jesus Christ. I fixed the spelling errors in the address on top. Some idiot misspelled unknown. It bothers me that our previous letters had that mistake on them so that everyone can see. How are we going to gain respect from the people of this stinking town if our spelling and grammar is inadequate? Okay, now that I'm done ranting, I want to inform you that we're no longer giving any of the pawns and officers coffee. We, on the top of the ladder, have to be fiscally responsible, which means we keep the coffee for ourselves. You want coffee? Too bad. You're going to have to work hard if you want to get promoted. And by working hard, we mean make us money. Ha 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 ha. Letter over, Frost. Yeah, that's him. Old Man Frost. Let me show you a picture of Old Man Frost. I got him. I drew him a long time ago in his official portrait. Oh man, I got to show you these Starhammer portraits. All right, after that, then I'm ending the stream. I'm keeping you guys up late at night. Business cards. Yes, I got to put that as a joke in the comic. Yes, they will make an appearance in episode 16, so I'll be putting that in. Nice. Okay. Villains, Starhammer, yeah. Okay, we're going to open. Yeah. This is the only way you'll see him. No, I didn't mean to do that. Jeez. Control, delete, yes. Sorry, I accidentally copied a whole bunch of pictures when I was trying to open them. Yeah, just like that. Come on. All right. Yeah, after I'm done showing these off, then I'm off. And I'll let you guys sleep. I gotta go to sleep too. Okay. Starhammer portraits. This is Tori. She is the secretary. She remember in that one quickie she interviewed Mike Machaud, who wanted to be in Starhammer. So she's like, okay, you can join. So yeah, she's the secretary. Grunt Pascal. He is part of the robbery division, and you saw him episode 12. I don't know if I should show this because it's spoiler. Maybe? Nah, okay. I mean, seeing that there's only five of you, and I'm going to reward you for loving my stream so much, so okay. Here we go. Rika. This is Officer Rika from the... She's an officer in the Creative Schemes Division? Yeah. Yeah, secretaries do run the business in a way. Yeah, she is responsible of who joins, you know. Yeah, this girl, Rika, we will see her in episode 21 when Jeff and Tara go on a double date and Jeff will be dating her. Yeah, that'll be interesting. Grunt Listo. Listo is Spanish for ready. Some people mispronounce his name as Listo. So it's like, oh, whatever. He doesn't care. He's a high level grunt in the robbery division. You see in episode 12. And if you've seen episode 13, you know who this guy is. Oh my gosh, it's Ralph Bronson. Yeah, he's now part of Team Starhammer now. Ever since his little plan failed, I gotta do that. Man, I gotta do that. Explaining episode 13. I try to do that multiple times, but I keep messing up. You know, I do this little series called Let's Look at JNT Episodes. And I've done every episode from 1 to 12, but I haven't done 13 yet. And I got to do that. I got to explain this guy. Yeah, he had a little run-in with Jeff and Taylor in an island with spyware puppets, and he got defeated. But Team Starhammer picked him up. He's crazy, but he knows how to. He's a great engineer and computer programmer. The lovable Frank. Yeah, this is the guy. We've seen him in Starhammer's very first appearance in episode 5. You know, that episode that I don't want anybody to read because it's so terrible. The art and the story. Yeah, that's where he made his debut. Frank. He's nice. You know, he used to be one of my Team Rocket members whenever I made Pokemon. Officer Burma. She is the other one. The other, she's the one that Taylor is going to date in that one episode. And in the outside world, everybody calls her May. There she is, yep. We all know this Joker. It's Arse Boy. Yeah, Arse Boy from that one quickie. All right. Team Rocket, yeah. Photo not available. I do this whenever I talk about, or whenever I put, Risotto's face or something. I have not drawn certain Starhammer members yet, of course. This goes for a certain somebody. And Risotto. And we all know him. He is Jacob. But he goes by Maricino. He had another name that I was going to call him. But, I stuck with Maricino, even though the other name was a bit better. I don't know. Whenever I hear Maricino, I think Cherry. And I was like, whatever. Okay. Sawyer, he is the manager of the robbery department, and he is based off of a YouTuber called Slowbeef, who I like. You know, he does little playthroughs of these bad games, and he's pretty funny, you know, down to earth and everything. Amaretto, the other general. We've seen him in episode 14. Zion, the weird guy in the robbery division. He has the weirdest lines to say. All right, this is Maxine. Yeah, I drew her way back in the day, 2013. That's when I first drew her. She's the one who wants all the cult stuff. Trixie, she is a high-level grunt in the tech department. Here he is. Here's Frost with his Bill Cosby sweater. Yep, that's him. You've seen him in episode 14. Schmidt, he's in episode 12 in the robbery department. And he is based off of an annoying co-worker that I used to work with. Executive Beck. He likes to dabble in the tech department. You can say he's a mix between Hugo Strange and Mr. T. Grunt Rocky. Yeah, he's the first guy I designed for Team Starhammer, even though he used to be in Team Rocket. In fact, his look is from a generic Rocket guy. Maricino. How do you spell that? Maricino? Maricino? Hold on. I'll look it up. Maricino. Maricino. Oh, yeah. It's Maricino. So, Mara Schino, or something like that. That's how you spell it. Maricino. And I see it's based off of a liquor. Liquor of cherries. Okay. What am I doing? Okay. So you had it right the first time, only add an S between the A and the C. That's how you spell it, Maricino. And the other executive, 8-Ball, he wears a respirator because he's germophobic. But, you know, he's very intimidating. He's very tall and everything. Yeah, that's it. That's it for the Starhammer people. So yeah, I wish you guys a lovely night, and thank you so much for joining the stream. I got a long day ahead of me tomorrow, and yeah, I gotta rest up. So, I'll see you guys later. Have a wonderful night. JFM out. Goodbye. Unless you have something else to say.
I think I've wasted too much time.
Jeff, do you drink to come up with these, or are you just that creative? I'm just that creative. I don't drink. I don't do drugs or anything. Well, I drink on occasion, you know, here and there. Rarely, it depends. But I don't smoke or anything. You know, I don't do drugs like that. Yeah, I'm just that creative. All right, thank you guys so much. Thank you guys. I love you guys too. All right. So, that's it for me. I'll see you guys later. I should drink some water. My throat is starting to hurt. All right. So, that's it. JFM out. Goodbye.